This great JSON formatting sample would give your hyperlinks a much needed facelift. It'll let users know where they'll be taken to before they click it. I think it's something you really need to see, so let's just get into it. Now, all users are becoming much more suspicious of clicking on links if they don't know where the link goes to, even on their own intranet. Let's make it easy for them. I'm here on my site. I've just got a bare blank list. There's nothing in here. We're going to just add a few items in here, and then we're going to apply this JSON formatting sample that is free, completely free, and we're going to see how that's going to change this. So let me add in a new hyperlink column. I'll just call this URL, and we just click save. Now, let me add in a few items, and then we'll start customizing this. Now, we do want to put in the alt text here. So whatever's in the title, probably you just copy it here. You could leave the title blank if you want to. It's just a habit of mine to always put in a title. Okay, so we've got some items here. You can see that the URL by default, it's just the alt text of the site hyperlinked to the URL. Now, you may think, well, it's obvious where a link is going to because you could just hover over it and you see down on the bottom left what URL it's going to go to. That doesn't always work necessarily. And a lot of users don't even pay attention to the fact that it's down there. It's been down there for decades, I think now. But a lot of people just don't notice it. So we're going to make it more obvious to them. So the first thing we're going to do is check out this sample. So this, it was created by two people, Watana and Tetsuya Kawahara. I actually showed one of Tetsuya's samples last week as well. So we've got two different things that this can do. This because there's two different JSON samples in here. You'll see a summary of information of like what this thing can do, the example of what it's going to look like. You'll see that we'll still have the item here with the alt text that's hyperlinked. And then you'll see below it, just in straight old text, the actual URL. So that's going to let the users know where they'll be taken to before they click on that link. You'll see another one where it's going to, if it's an image that you're going to be applying this to, like an image library, it can show them a preview of that image as well. We're going to be doing the first option here, the leftmost column. You'll see when this was created, this actually was just created this year, well, a month or two ago. So very, very recent sample. So what we're going to do is click on the hyperlink display URL format hyperlink.json. And there's not much here. We're going to go through this. I'm going to explain exactly how this thing works so that you can start to learn some of this stuff. But for now, we're just going to click on this copy raw file button right here. And we'll go back to our list and we're going to be customizing. We're going to be formatting, the URL column. So we'll click on this down arrow for the column heading. We'll go to column settings and format this column. We can click on advanced mode to go see the actual code, the actual JSON formatter. We can drag this window out to see it a little bit better. We're going to highlight everything, delete everything because we have everything we need already copied into our clipboard. And then we're just going to paste it in and hit save. Now we may have to give this a couple of refreshes. And now we see that our list, our column has been formatted just the way we saw in the screenshot from that sample. We'll be able to see that we could still hover over this link. It's still going, it's going to the correct place. And then there's the text version right down here. What's neat about this is you can copy this and just paste it straight into a new tab. So if somebody would prefer to, they can manually copy it into that. So your users have two different ways. They can just click like most will do. Then the ones that are more suspicious, they would prefer to probably copy and paste the URL. Certainly the people in IT would probably be doing that. So in any case, we have this thing working. It's done. But how does this thing work? Let's look back at the code and let's step through what this thing is doing. Now, I know this is going to look complex to you, and you might be thinking, hey, I'm not a developer, and I get it, but you don't have to actually be a developer to use these things and to even start customizing or creating them from scratch. I actually created an online course to teach you how all this works. If you're interested, I've got a link in the description, but let's just keep going through this. So what we're seeing here is a column formatter. We'll know that it's a column formatter because we see that right here in the schema file. It's a column formatting schema. The schema is just the rules that this file will follow with what types of text you could put in here. It'll create an HTML div. We'll see that with an element type of div. And then inside there, which we know because of the children tag here, inside there, it's going to create another div. A div is just a container. And inside there, we're going to set the display to flex if we have a value. If we don't have a value, if current field, which is our URL field, if there's no value in there, it's just not going to display anything. And then it's going to set up the container so that it will list things down vertically. That's how we got this vertical layout right here. We have the link, and then below that we have the text. No matter how long or short they are, they'll be vertical because it was specified here in this flex direction. We'll set a margin so that there's some padding around that, so that it's not bumping up against the edges of this container. You see here, like especially on the top and bottom, you see that there's some extra spacing here. That's because of things like the margin. Now inside there, we're going to create a hyperlink, because that's the first thing that we have here is just the actual hyperlink. That's an A tag in HTML speak. Well, the text that you see on the screen is going to be set to the current field description. In this case, that's the alternate text. And if there's nothing in there, it'll just display no alternate text. The URL for the hyperlink is going to be the value of that URL. And it says a target is equal to blank. That just means it's going to open up in a new tab. You could get rid of this if you wanted it to open up in the same tab. So whatever tab that the user was on, it just reuses that same tab. If you're going to somewhere outside of that particular SharePoint site, then it's common practice to open in a new tab. Otherwise, you could just reuse the same one. And then we create another div. This is going to actually be the text part that you could copy and paste if you wanted to. It'll just be another div. And the text content is just equal to the current field. So that's the URL itself. It's just going to be in there as text. And then a little bit of CSS styling to handle the word breaks. And then under the attributes, we're setting this, adding a CSS class so that the font size is extra small. This is one of the built-in Microsoft classes you could use to style things without having to really do much else. You could reference some of these quick things that Microsoft provides in their documentation to just make the text small. And that's why we see that this text is smaller than the Microsoft Learn in this article or this item. So that's really all there is to this. You can take this and do a lot more with it. You can add in background colors. You can change the font colors. You can do a lot of stuff because you have all of the formatting code right here. And with a little bit of HTML and a little bit of CSS, or just some experimentation and looking up how to do things with CSS or HTML, you can do a lot with this to customize it, make it your own, and come up with something truly unique. So there's a whole lot of these free samples in this library. This is part of the Microsoft 365 and Power Platform community library. There's a ton, as you see here, if we go to column samples, a ton of these examples that you can use for any number of reasons. I've got a playlist that has covered a lot of these things. So if you want to see what else JSON formatting can do for you and your organization, just click or tap the screen to get started, and I'll see you on the next one.